लक्ष्मी नारायण कंसल्टेंट फूड टेक्नोलॉजी. वेलकम यू सर फॉर दिस वेबिनार एज ए स्पीकर. वी कंडक्टेड ए सीरीज ऑफ वेबिनार दिस सीजन एंड दिस इज द फिफ्थ एंड द लास्ट वेबिनार इन द सीरीज. टिल नाउ वी कंडक्टेड the webinar by the experts in the field of taxonomy. These webinars were conducted mainly to create a sort of interest in taxonomy amongst the students and to understand the relationship of these plants and their uses in the different fields. So as a concluding part today, we are having a webinar by an eminent personality who would address the application of the entire plant science, the study of plant science, and the use of the study of plant science as a career after their graduation. With this intention, we would welcome you all for this webinar. This is the last of the webinar series from the Botany and Microbiology Departments, Vijaya College, in association with IQAC also. I welcome all of you for this webinar very cordially. I take this privilege to introduce today's webinar, the guest speaker, Dr. C.S. Lakshmi Narayana. He is a consultant food technology. He got the BSc honors, and after that he acquired MSc in agriculture from Jawaharlal Nehru Agriculture University, Jabalpur, and then went on to complete his PhD in agriculture from Central Rice Research Institute, Cuttack. After his education, he has taken the field of food technology as his area of work and has got several achievements in this field. He has set up a unit for commercial production of microbial enzymes for fruit processing industries, set up a unit for commercial production of cashew feni near Kundapura to help farmers financially, has developed fruit products for Himachal Pradesh Horticultural Produce Processing and Marketing Corporation, Shimla, joined RK Instant Foods Bengaluru as general manager. During this period of over a decade, developed and improved a number of instant food mixes accepted by consumers. We are all aware of the products from RK food industries. Then he joined Vittal Mallya Scientific Research Foundation, Bengaluru, as scientist. During this period, Solunim, a water-soluble insecticide from neem seed kernel, was standardized for commercial production. This product was exported to United States and several crores earned out of it. A product for dust mites was standardized for commercial production, marketed under the trademark Checkmite. Research was initiated to enhance antioxidants of guava by fermentation. Hydroxycitric acid for weight management was standardized. He is now working as a consultant for BRICS, HPMC, and other food industries. And apart from the achievements in his field of food technology, as a person, he is a very learned person and a very kind person who would be there to help anybody who approaches him. I have sent a few of my students and other persons who would be interested to start some ventures in the botanical field and biotechnology and other, and they have approached him and many more will be approaching him for his help. He is there as a guide in this field for anybody who would approach him. He is a very helpful personality and a kind personality and very learned one. And we are fortunate to have you here, sir, for the webinar to address our students and other academicians. And we are very proud of having you as the guest speaker for today's webinar. Thank you. Well, I welcome you, sir, for this webinar. And now I request you to take over the webinar. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon. Can you hear me, madam?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is centenary year for botany in Central College, and we celebrated this with many programs. Professor Kameshwar Rao initiated a lecture series, and many speakers delivered talk in various colleges. And I also got an opportunity to give lecture in 3 colleges. In continuation, this webinar is being organized by Vijaya College. I thank Principal and Madam Shailaja, Madam, for having organized this webinar and started this webinar series in continuation of our program. Respect to centenary celebration. So now, plants have been very useful as food and medicinal for a long time. Apart from this, they are useful in many other ways which are not explored. So many plants have properties which we can explore and make plant products by reducing the synthetic chemicals, and which will reduce pollution also. So our intention was to study these plants, do research, develop products to reduce the pollution for it, and it should be useful for human welfare. So we selected certain plants, did some research work in that line, and developed products for human welfare and at the same time without polluting the atmosphere. I will illustrate now the plants where we studied and explain you how the products we developed. We are able to develop the products for human welfare. So first I would like to go with neem. You are all familiar with this plant, bevo. This neem plant is native to southern and southeastern Asia and specially concentrated in India. It is known as village pharmacy, as people were using them as for variety of ailments. Swarm of locusts never touched it because it was sprayed with neem extract. Because earlier these farmers used to soak these leaves in water and spray it on plants to ward off insects. So later in 1970, Dr. Morgan and team, they extracted a compound from neem kernels known to have insecticide properties and named it as azadirachtin. So in India, people also have started extracting this insecticide extracting compound from this neem scent kernel and used it as insecticide. But one issue was it contained about 60% to 70% chemical. So this chemical, though it is partially effective against insects, when you spray it on plants, it pollutes the atmosphere, and if it falls on soil, it will pollute the soil. So in Vittal Mallya Scientific Research Foundation, we started thinking that we should develop a product which should not pollute the atmosphere or the soil. At the same time, it should be effective against insects. So over a decade, we did research and developed one product, which is water-soluble neem insecticide. It is a systemic bioinsecticide for organic, safe, and functional food production. So this is a patent. We have got patent on this. US patent is there. Soloneem contains 6% azadirachtin as the main ingredient. So now about Soloneem, I would like to explain. Soloneem is the world's first water-soluble neem-based bioinsecticide powder made from neem seed kernel extract. It is a spray-dried powder freely soluble in water and protected. It is systemic in nature. It can be taken up by plants and the efficacy retains for a longer time in plant. At the same time, it does not pollute either the atmosphere nor the soil. And it is extremely safe for humans, pets, and beneficial organisms. And another advantage is controls a broad spectrum of insects, aphids, whiteflies, mealybugs, thrips. It is very effective against all these insects. But we have one problem. Because it involves a long process and expensive chemicals, the overall product becomes expensive. It may cost more than 15,000 to 20,000 per kg. So this may not be affordable by our farmers. But it is good for export, so we could export in a large quantity and earned crores of rupees. But then we thought, how to give a comparable product and cost-effective product to our farmers. So then we started working on that line. So we developed a product, neem-based product, Neem Ratan or Neem Shakti. So this is also a water-soluble insecticide having the same properties and with 3000 ppm of azadirachtin, and it is cost effective and it could be used by our farmers. So that's how we could overcome this cost for our farmers and develop this product. So next is, again, we thought of utilizing this neem seed extract in other farms. One is checkmite. What is checkmite? See, in house dust, it is associated with mites. So these mites in dust causes allergy. So we have to ward off these mites in our house to be free from these allergic complications. So we spray, it is a spray, aerosol spray for this control of house dust mites by using this neem seed extract. It is biodegradable and safe for humans and pet animals also. So that's how we could produce another product, checkmite. So this is about neem. Now I will take up another interesting feature. Nanoparticles. See, what are nanoparticles? Because now in the field of information technology, medicine, energy, all this, it is playing a very important role. Because with nanoparticles, the efficacy is much more than the normal product. So but how these plants are influencing, how plants can be utilized in producing these nanoparticles? That is what we thought of giving you the information. Plants are very useful for this production of these nanoparticles. So it is can be used in, these nanoparticles are used in various ways, information technology, medicine like cancer treatment, bone treatment, all these ways in the energy and consumer goods also. So now plant extracts can be used as a tool for nanoparticles. The advantages is it provides single step biosynthesis process and protocols involving free from toxicant and natural capping agents. It can generate bimetallic silver and gold shell nanoparticles. It is excellent stability and size control. It is very cost effective. Large scale production of metallic, it can be done. And semiconductor and metal oxide nanoparticles. The process involved in nanoparticle synthesis is natural reducing agent, then goes to the metal solution, extract, stirring, and then it becomes nanoparticles. So now these are the advantages of plant extracts as reducing agents, because this plant contains these phytoconstituents, tannins, alkaloids, polyphenols, flavonoids, citric acid. They are very good reducing agents, easily available, cost effective, and eco-friendly. So these are the plants normally used for nanoparticle synthesis. Azadirachta, recta, aloe vera, cinnamomum, moraya, like this. These are the plants which are useful. So in nanoparticles also, these plants play an important role and they can be used. And another recent research I would like to add about nanoparticle. In Christ College, Dr. Manoj and team, they developed one antibacterial agent. One problem was there, the Pseudomonas aeruginosa, which is multi-drug resistant. It cannot be effectively killed by any antibiotics, anything. So these people, they worked with, combined with physics department and biology department, they developed an antimicrobial agent from coconut shell, and through nanotechnology, they developed a compound, and it is very effective against a multi-drug resistant Pseudomonas aeruginosa, a common contaminant in hospital. So now they have done it on lab scale, and they have to take up on a large scale trials, and they have to improve the product. So that's how nanoparticles can be used in various applications. Now, another interesting where you can use these nanoparticles, plant cellulose. Plant cellulose also may be used to create bone implants. So plant cellulose, they use to develop a strong lightweight sponge to be used as a bone implant. It is developed by research from the University of British Columbia, and it is made by treating nanocrystals derived from plant cellulose. So that's how these nanoparticles can be made by use of this plants and plant cellulose and so on. Now another interesting thing about water hyacinth. Water hyacinth, Icornia crassipes, it's a water weed. And we know it actually purifies also water. It is takes up these heavy metals also from water, running water if you may, and it can absorb heavy metals and purify water also. But in Kerala, one teacher, she thought it can be used as a biodegradable sanitary napkins, because this, it has a stem which is very spongy. It can absorb water about 12 times than a regular sanitary pad. So she developed, she thought how it can be used for these sanitary napkins, and she developed sanitary napkins, and it is completely disposable or can be converted into compost. So this is how we can think of utilizing our plant in various ways other than food and medicine or any other uses. Now another plant we'll take up next is papaya. You are all familiar with this papaya, Carica papaya. Originally it is from southern Mexico, Central America, northern South America, and it is cultivated in most tropical countries. Earlier only the ripe fruit was used, eaten raw without skin or seeds, but green papaya was used in cooking and also for tenderizing meat. another one enzyme, it has one enzyme, proteolytic enzyme. It is extracted from fruit and known as papain. So this enzyme, earlier it was used as only for digestive aid. So we thought of utilizing this enzyme and developing a product that is for oral health products. Here I will tell you, in many teeth get infected, it develop caries. So in the dentist, first he has to clean this caries, remove this caries. After that only he can start any treatment, whatever is required for that. But earlier, how to remove this caries? It is sticking to the teeth. So dentist used to use this motorized burr to remove this caries because they're very hard. When they were using this burr, they don't know how much they are removing the teeth. Thereby, they were able to not only remove the caries, but they were removing the healthy portion of the teeth also. In restorative procedure, the aim is to retain as much as possible the teeth. So they had this problem. Then we developed an enzyme, this papain enzyme based gel formulation for non-invasive and non-traumatic removal of the debris. This technique involves, if you apply just gel, within 1 minute or 1.5 minutes, it will dissolve this caries, and it easily it can be removed. And after removal of this caries, the treatment can be started. So it can be effectively used in restorative dental procedure. And we got a patent for this one, and it is being commercially marketed as carie care. Then we thought of improving this. Then we developed another product, carie clean, where we utilize this bromelain. This is also a proteolytic enzyme from pineapple, and by combining this and with another xylitol sugar, which is antimicrobial, we could improve this product, and this gives a better removal of caries, and it is antimicrobial also. I'll just showing here how to remove how caries is removed. It is in A, it is just caries is there. B, gel is applied. C is it is dissolved. Then D is it is free from this one. So it is a unique gel. Now I will show you in video also how it is removed. See in this, you can see the caries. Now this blue color, it is gel. Gel is applied. It is softened. You can remove from excavator easily. Just out of the cavity. So this is very useful for especially for children and aged people, otherwise they will have to bear the pain. So this is that way this is very useful. So next, coming to this is interesting, another xylitol sugar. We thought of utilizing and developing another two products, that is, one is mouthwash and denture wash. Because this xylitol is a polyalcohol sugar, it is sugar from polyalcohol and from maize. So this cannot be utilized by microorganisms. So this property we utilized and developed mouthwash and denture wash. By this can even effective against candida yeast also. So this also has been in dental colleges we have given, and they have tried, and it is quite effective. Then another product, now you might be knowing, when the dengue fever, the platelets will come down. So best way is this papaya leaf juice. When you give it, it will boost this platelets. But the problem is you cannot take directly the juice. It is little difficult because vomiting and other things. So this micro lab people, they developed a product by utilizing this Pyrica papaya leaf extract, and they have developed tablets for this, and known as carry pill. Another is fermented papaya product. See, the papaya has got this antioxidants. Antioxidants are required to nullify these free radicals which are generated in the body. So this, but this whatever the antioxidants, enhancement is required for this. So this Japan, they developed a product by fermentation and known as fermented papaya product, and they are commercially known as Immunage. So this contains high quantity of antioxidants, and when given to old age people, it can contain this old age related diseases. So now you can think of one papaya plant, how many uses which are not knowing, now it can be utilized in many ways, and products have been developed. Now coming to next one is Goa, Cidium Goa. It is it's poor man's apple, but nowadays it is also quite expensive and highly remunerative dry land crop, and there are many products. But we thought of improving again antioxidants, as such products are available, but we thought of increasing the antioxidants. So we, by utilizing this Lactobacillus plantarum, we fermented the product and increased the antioxidants. So this is the process: fresh raw guava, then grated guava, then fermented medium, then pasteurization. This is the process how we did: fermenter and assay, centrifugal separation. Finally, we get the fermented guava product, and it can be blended with many other products, and it can be taken. This has also got same properties as fermented papaya product. And another next plant is we worked with Garcinia. Garcinia cambogia, commonly known as Malabar tamarind or kokum, and it generally grows in coastal Karnataka and Kerala. And we developed we extracted from this one and developed the product, which is we gave it on royalty to several companies and earned again same crores of rupees as royalty, and it is being exported, and it is used in many products in foreign countries, exported also. Now it is coming in tablet form also. So we could develop this. It is, the main ingredient is hydroxycitric acid. So this can be used in diet food, drinks, confectionaries, slimming formulations, and it is quite stable, taste natural, tasteless, colorless. And this technology also we developed. These are the products available, tablets and capsules. And now even in here also, people have started using, and tablets are being made. Another interesting next plant we'll take up is Moringa. Moringa, you already know, nugge. So nugge fruits are used in a huge quantity. Then leaf has got many nutritive substances. It contains vitamins, riboflavin, magnesium, rich in oxidants. It is very useful. But we cannot use directly as it causes some nausea and other things. And even decaf, if you use it, is really good. but it is little difficult. So we developed the tablets. Many capsules and tablets have been produced. But again, one problem is if you directly take this product capsule or tablets, it may not assimilate. Nutrients may not be absorbed in a proper way. So we developed another product, Moringa Tab and NutriTab. What I have done is, in Moringa Tab, these ingredients are drumstick leaf, curry leaf, and ginger powder. So this ginger powder, curry leaf, they help in digestion and assimilation process. Thereby, whatever the nutrients are there in from Moringa, it is absorbed completely, and it gives good nutrition and other properties also. It when consumed removes fatigue, gives strength to the body and overcome anemia and other things also. It has got fiber content and controls constipation and nutrition supplement, hormonal balance, stress, anxiety, and so on. Another product tablets we developed is NutriTab. In NutriTab, we added rice bran also. That also helps in better assimilation and better absorption of nutrients. So now, coming to another two interesting plants, soap nut and shikakai. Already people are using it in their own way. It is not new to this. But what we have done is, we have extracted from this and developed easily consumer friendly products. With several products we have developed, and it is known as Soap of India. It contains saponins, a natural surfactant in it, and traditionally it is being already using for bathing, washing clothes and other things. Now we have developed so many products, and it is environmentally friendly alternative to chemical detergent. So this is known as natural cleansers. Why we have to make use of natural cleansers? One is, it is non-toxic and sustainable, and it is biodegradable. It is mild on skin and safe on clothes, eco-friendly alternatives, and value addition to natural resource. And it helps farming community also. When you are using this, we are not using any chemical, it helps farming community. We formed a company, Biological Research Innovation Center and Solution, and developed all these products, and now they are being marketed. And we have designed various products by utilizing these two plants, and we have developed products. I will tell you one by one what we have developed. Natural fabric wash. See, normally when you use this chemical for washing clothes, in either in washing machine or otherwise, and you are leaving to the water body. When it goes to the water body, it pollutes. What you have seen in Bellandur Lake, what happened there, the foam and other thing is because of chemicals coming from all these sources. So when you use this one, it doesn't pollute the water bodies, and it is chemical free, and it is made from natural ingredients and easy to use, and it is completely biodegradable, and it is quite effective against removing the dirt, grime, oil residues from clothes, and it is safe on skin also. So this is one product. Next is dishwash. See, in household, ladies are using this dishwash from chemicals, but if you continuously use, probably you may get even allergy reaction on palms and fingers and other things. So by using this one, which contains only from soap nut and shikakai extract, it is safe on your hands, safe on your skin, and it is effective and safe to wash, remove sticky food smell, oil residues, everything. It is quite effective, and it is being marketed now, and people are encouraging. Another advantage is, low leather product, its leather is not coming much, thereby you are not using much water. When you use other dishwash products, it produces lot of foam and you have to use more water to ward it off. But here you are using less water. Then surface cleaner, it is also similar to that. You can use it for surface cleaning to remove the dirt and other things from surface. And you may be surprised to know why attached toilet cleaner. It is the same thing. When you are using chemical toilet cleaners, goes into the water body and again it is polluting. So at least to some extent, if you use this natural toilet cleaner, you are reducing the pollution. You are not allowing chemicals to water bodies, thereby you are not polluting. So this also we have developed. And finally, hand wash. Nowadays, you know, natural hand wash. Hand wash is very much in use. You have to use frequently, especially after corona, you have to frequently use it. And if you suppose use it very frequently, the chemical hand wash, probably you may, some allergic reaction may come, at least to some percentage of people. So if you use this one, made from natural products, you don't get the allergic reaction and it is quite effective. And again, same thing, it doesn't produce much lather. So thereby you are conserving water also. So these are all the products recently we have produced and we are marketing through organic stores, nothing, and people are encouraging, people are using. Natural face wash also we have made. It is similar to those products. And then shampoo also we have made from this one, which has got the same advantages, chemical free and doesn't consume more water, doesn't produce more lather. Thereby you are conserving water and your water bodies also, you are not polluting. Bath and body wash. We have made one health drink mix. Of course, it is quite, people are using in many areas, Malnad areas, I think, but I have clubbed with many other ingredients also and made this drink mix. And we have been using for several years. And especially when you travel in Bangalore, lot of pollution. And when you come back after wandering in Bangalore, you may come up with throat irritation or cold, nothing. So if you drink this regularly, you are not getting irritation in the throat, and it has got digestive ingredients also, easily digest, it helps digestion also. So I have been using and we are not getting much cold, cough or anything. So this can be used. I'll tell you one incident also. I was traveling in auto. At that time I was just discussing about this product with my friend through phone. Auto driver listened to this and he asked me, what is this? Then I just told him, this is the thing. Then he was interested, sir, I'm wandering and I will having this problem. Then I, through WhatsApp, I sent all the details. He prepared and he used it for 1 month. After 1 month, he called me. Then he said, it is really good. I don't have much problem now. I'm using it. So that way I just wanted to share with you all. You can use it, especially now, even it gives you immunity also against this viral. Summing up all my talk, what I want, the problems and opportunities. Natural products, a way forward. So early, now what is happening? Chemical intervention in consumer products. Earlier we were using mostly natural products, but now because of chemical intervention has come in all consumer products. Unscrupulous usage of harsh chemicals in consumer products. Now they are using a lot of harsh chemicals in consumer product, which is affecting our health as well as environment. And shift from traditional eco-friendly living to chemical-driven products. Earlier we were all using eco-friendly living in many either washing or personal health care products. We are using natural products. Now because of this intervention with chemical, now we are using chemical-driven products. These are the problems. But what we have to do? So natural and eco-friendly products, first we have to find out availability of natural resource and they are underutilized. Next is we have to bring awareness among people to utilize more of natural products. Then potential customers, we have to identify potential customers, then prospective marketplace, and state also should support. With all these, then we can avoid these chemicals going into the water bodies and polluting not only water, even air. Air pollution, water pollution can be controlled, and not only that, even our health also can be protected. And we, of course, these things, you know, will not be known immediately. When you continuously use it after several years, you will find some problem, and then you cannot, you cannot come back, and it is difficult to be free from that effect. So better to use natural products. So this was our aim. With this one we developed the products, botanical products from natural plant material. At the same time, we should not, the product should not, when you after use, should not create pollution either to air or water. So this is how I thank once again the principal, Vijaya College, and Shailaja madam for having given me an opportunity to explain this and starting this webinar series for our centenary celebration. Thank you all.